Okay, today we're going to show you how we make a Harry Potter wand. First, I select the piece of wood that I'm going to use. Today I'm going to use a Bolivian rosewood to round it off and make a dowel, because a lot of times what you'll do is when you buy the wood, you'll get a squared edge just like this, and you're going to have to round it out so you can put it on the lathe just right over here. But the wand I'm actually going to make today is made out of zebra wood, which is a type of exotic wood. But to show you how I round it out and make a dowel, we're going to use this Bolivian rosewood today. So what we do is we take this piece of wood and we use what is called a router. Now this router has a rounded edge, and you stick it through here and it rounds all these edges so it makes kind of a circular cylinder, which is what we call a dowel. So, my assistant, my son, is going to help me out today. We need to get your headphones on because it's going to be really loud. I'll get mine on. Come over here. Stand up so you can watch. Let me flip the switch. Let me round out each corner just like this. Not quite perfect, but it's good enough to do the job. We just needed to round it out a little bit so when we turn it on the lathe, we can shave it just a little bit easier, and it's not going to have any jagged edges or anything like that. So there we go. Okay, what we do next is we take our cylinder that we just created out of wood, and then I place it on this lathe right here. I had to tighten it really tight so when we turn it, it won't come off. Now, I'm going to turn it on. And it'll turn just like that. And then I start out by using my grinder that I put a sander on the edge of it, because it's gets the job done a little bit faster. And then I start sanding the edges and sand it down to where there's no more bumps or grooves on there. Just make it as smooth as I can and kind of narrow it out into the shape of a wand, a little bit like this. Okay, now if I want to make any really major grooves on this dowel right here to cut it down and kind of make those knobs or anything like that that I make on the wands, well, I use my tool right here, my Dremel, and I just kind of carve into this end like this. Okay, now that I have it the shape that I really want it, Daddy. What's going to take most of the time, actually, is the sanding. And that's the most boring part, really. Because what I do is I take a really thicker sand and I let it sand as it's turning, and then I have to sand it with this thick sanding paper, and then I have to get really fine sanding paper and do that next so that it becomes really, really smooth. Right now it's super, super rough and jagged, and it's going to have to take a lot of sanding in order to get it as smooth as I'd like it. So, let's get it going. All right, now that I've taken it off the lathe, I still have these knobby edges right here that I need to take off. Instead of cutting them off, what I like to do is I like to sand them with my sander machine and kind of round the edges and make it so it blends it in just a little bit. It does take a little bit of time. Okay, what I then like to do is I like to burn the name of the wood into the wand so that those who are looking at the wand know what type of wood it is. And this one, since it's zebra wood, I drew zebra wood in first in pen, and then I'm going to use my burning pen to burn it into the wood before... Alright, now we're on the last step. We need to put a clear coat on this wand. I will probably put anywhere from 2 to 3 different clear coats. We put one on, give it about an hour to dry, and then put another one on. So, we'll start doing that. After a few coats, it's done. This process can take anywhere from 2 to 5 hours depending on how complex the design is, as well as the wood. Hope you enjoy.